Okay, so good afternoon to all of you. So today we are going to discuss on the topic of IPsec, right? So the security part of the IPsec, we are going to talk and discuss. Just a minute. So we are going to talk and discuss on the topic of IPsec. So this is a part of the security. We are going to talk about the security of network layer. So the security that is present in our network layer, we are going to discuss on that security of network layer. So the part, the security of network layer. What is the security present? How the things goes on? We are going to talk. So this network layer security have different type of protocols, different type of controls, and these security controls have been used frequently for securing the communication, particularly over the shared network, such as the internet, because it can provide protection for many applications at once without modifying them. So the network layer security controls used frequently in which cases? It is used frequently for the purpose of securing the communication, for securing communications, right? Next, after that, the securing communication also over a shared network such as the internet, it can provide protection for many applications at once. So this real-time security protocol, there are many such type of real-time security protocols that have evolved for the network security, ensuring basic tenets of the security. And what are the basic components of the security comes here? The first one is called privacy. Second one is origin authentication. Privacy, origin authentication, message integrity, and non-repudiation. Message integrity. And lastly, non-repudiation. So these are the components that comes under the part of this security protocols: privacy, origin authentication, message integrity, non-repudiation. So the thing is, most of these protocols remain focused at the higher layers of this OSI protocol stack. So the protocols we are talking about, most of these particular protocols remain focused at the higher layer of the OSI protocols. And it is used to compensate for lack of security in standard internet protocol, such as that there is several type of SSL is developed specifically to secure application like HTTP or FTP. So SSL is used. SSL is used to secure the part of, we can say HTTP or FTP, secure the application like HTTP or FTP. So this actually, so these protocols we are talking about, they need to give a rise on the part or develop a security solution at the IP layer so that all the higher layer protocols could take advantage of it. So here we are going to talk on the security that is achieved at the network layer using the popular set of protocol, and the name of that particular protocol we are going to talk about is IPsec. We are going to talk on today about the topic of IPsec, right? So this security in the part of the network layer, there are different type of communication protocol and security protocol present in the different layers, right? So if I talk about, suppose okay, so now if I write the name of the layer, in the first case, if I write the name as application layer, if I write the name application layer, what is the communication protocol present in my application layer? That is known as HTTP, FTP, SMTP. So HTTP, FTP, SMTP, these are my communicating protocol. And what security protocol are present in my application layer? That is PGP, SMIME, HTTPS. PGP, SMIME, HTTPS. PGP, SMIME, and other one, HTTPS. So these are the protocol, that security protocol that is present. Now if I go for the second one, that is known as transport layer. Transport layer. So what are the things present in my transport layer? That is TCP or UDP. That is TCP or UDP. And what is present in the security protocol? SSL, TLS, SSH. SSL, TLS, SSH. And in the last one, if I write network layer. So what are the scenario present in my network layer? That is IP, the communicating protocol. And what are the security protocol present here? That is IPsec. So we are going to discuss on this particular topic of IP and IPsec that is present in my network layer. So we are going to basically talk on this particular part, the network layer, on the security protocol of IPsec. We are going to talk on this. So this IPsec, or this popular framework, it is a very popular framework which is developed for ensuring the security at network layer. So this popular framework was developed for ensuring the security at the network layer. So what are the features of this IPsec? So this IPsec, if I talk about the features of this IPsec, what are the features of the IPsec? The first feature of the IPsec, if I write, that's the first feature, very first feature of the IPsec, that it is not designed only to work with TCP as a transport protocol. It is not designed to work with TCP as a communicating protocol. Rather, it was designed also to work with UDP or any other protocol above IP. Rather, it is designed to work with UDP or any higher layer protocol or any higher layer type of protocol. So this is the first features of this IPsec. This is the very first feature of the IPsec. Second one, this IPsec actually protects the entire packet presented to the IP layer, including the higher layer headers. So this IPsec actually protects the entire packet presented to the IP layer, including the higher layer headers. So here IPsec again protects the entire packet that is presented to the IP layer. Third one, we can say higher layer headers are hidden, which carry port numbers. Traffic analysis is more difficult. So as the higher layer headers are hidden, as it carries the port numbers, traffic analysis is more difficult. Here, this IPsec work from one network entity to another network entity, from application process to the process. So this part of this IPsec, if we talk about the features with respect to the function, some security functions of this IPsec. What are the security function? If we talk about the security function of the IPsec, first one we can say confidentiality. So the first part that is known, that is confidentiality. Here the confidentiality means that it enables communicating nodes to encrypt messages. This IPsec enable communicating nodes. It enables communicating nodes to encrypt messages. Second part, also we can say that prevents eavesdropping by third parties. It also prevents eavesdropping by third party. So these are the two security functions in the scenario of this confidentiality of security function. Next part, that is origin authentication and data integrity. What happened here in the part of this origin authentication and data integrity? It provides assurance that a received packet was actually transmitted by the party. Identified as a source of the packet header, and confirms that the packet has not been altered. Third one, that is key management. So in the part of this key management, it allows the secure exchange of keys. It allows the secure exchange of keys and protection against certain types of security attacks, such as replay attacks. Now, what is the architecture of this IPsec? If we look for the architecture of this IPsec, how it looks like? Suppose IP IP security architecture. There are two parts. One is the ESP protocol and the one is AH protocol. So first let me draw that part. ESP protocol. Second one is AH protocol. Then in the ESP protocol side, encryption algorithm. Here, encryption algorithm. And in this part of AES protocol, authentication algorithm. Right now, after that, there is called key management part, the part that is present here, that is known as key management. So this is the simple architecture of this IP security architecture. Now, how the scenario actually flows? It flows something like this. Just a minute. So this is the simple architecture of this IPsec. So this IPsec is a suite of three transport level protocols used for the authentication of the origin and the, also the content of the IP packets. Also, on the other hand, the encryption algorithm for the data payload. So two of the protocols, one is authentication header protocol and encapsulating security payload. So the full form of AH. The full form of AH is known as authentication header. And secondly, the full form of ESP protocol, that is known as encapsulating security payload. Encapsulating security payload. So these are the two full form of ESP and AH. And in this part of this ESP and the AH, these are the two protocols that provide the authentication comprising the proof of data source, data integrity, anti-replay protection. And additionally, it is providing the data encryption. So the IPsec protocol, that is key management or the key exchange part, it is a complete hybrid protocol. Used for the peer-to-peer authentication and key exchange processes that necessarily precise the services provided by AH and ESP. Now, this IPsec protocol, it does not define which algorithm should be used for the computation involved in encryption or in generating digital signatures. So here we can say that this IPsec, it does not have any definition about which algorithm should be used, which type of algorithm should be used for the communication, for the computation involved in encryption or in generating some digital signatures. So this actually shows that the protocol definition completely generic, meaning that they can accommodate developments such as new cryptographic techniques as it becomes available. Now, again, the part of this VPN, the virtual private network that we have discussed in my previous classes, that comes under the scenario of this IPC. So we have talked about it, the topic of the basic ideas of EPN that we have talked. Now this IPC, what can be the operations that we can actually done with the expectation of IPSec? So this IPSec should actually can be considered having two separate operation. What are those? The two operation is, one is IPSec communication, second one is internet key exchange. Two operation that can be present here. First one is IPSec communication. Second one is IKE, that is internet key exchange. These two part, IPSec communication and internet key exchange, that is present here. So IPSec communication, it is typically associated with some standard IPSec functionality, and it involves the encapsulation, encryption, hashing with IP datagrams, and handling all packet processes. So the first part, the IPSec communication, is deal with the encapsulation. It deals with encapsulation. It deals with encapsulation. Then the part of encryption, hashing with IP datagram, encryption. Hashing with IP datagram. So these are the part that is involved in the part of this IPSec communication. Also, rather, it also responsible for managing the communication according to the available security associations between the communicating part, between the communicating parties. Secondly, it uses the security protocol such as authentication header and encapsulation SP. And IPSec communication is not involved in creation of keys or of their management. Now this part, the second part here, that is the internet key exchange. That is IKE. It is the automatic key management protocol for IPSec. It is the automatic key management protocol for IPSec actually. So IKE is the automatic key management protocol. It is an automatic key management protocol for IPSec. Here, the actually means that its key management is not essential for IPSec communication. The keys can be manually managed. However, manual key management is not desirable for large network. So if we are going to manage the key for a large network manually, then it will create a hectic problem. And this is responsible for creation of keys for IPSec. Creation for keys of IPSec. And there are several type of communicating mode for this IPSec. What are the communicating mode? It basically is IPSec communication has two mode of functioning. One is transport mode. First one is transport mode. Second one is tunnel mode. So two different type of mode that is present here, transport mode and tunnel mode. And this IPSec is actually does not encapsulate a packet received from the upper layer. This IPSec does not encapsulate a packet received from the upper layer. The original IP header is managed and the data is forwarded based on the original attributes set by the upper layer protocol. So what is happening in the part of this transport mode? Just a minute. So what we are seeing that the transport mode, that this IPsec does not encapsulate a packet received from the any upper layer, and the original IP header is maintained and the data is forwarded based on the original attribute set by any type of upper layer protocol. So here is a diagram that will show the data flow of the IPsec protocol stack, how it looks like. So the scenario, let me draw it first. First, there is a network. So there is a network. Then there are several parts of the header. Just a minute. So there are three different parts. Okay, so first one, it is present here as IP header. Second one, that is present here, TCP header. And lastly, here, that is data. Okay, now in the part, the IP header and this network information is applied here. Then what happened? The IPsec actually isolated the IP header from the upper layer data. The IPsec actually change or actually isolates the IP header from upper layer data. So means that here the IP header, this part, will be isolated from these two parts in the second cases, right? So what happened? The next diagram will be look like. So this is my IP header. This is my TCP header. This is my data. And this part was isolated with the help of this IPsec. So IPsec actually isolated this particular part from any upper layer data. Next, what happened? Some IPsec applies some security protocol here. So in this part, some security protocol was added. What security protocol here was added? That is ESP-AH. What is added here? That is ESP. The thing that is added here in the next part. One is added here. One is added here. What is added here? Here is ESP-AH. And here that is added, that ESP TRL. So these things was added, and this was already there. This IP header will be there, TCP header and data will be there. With combination of this, one ESP AH and ESP TRL was added in the scenario. And lastly, the packets were reassembled. Means again, all the things, the total of this scenario was merged. This total, this IP header, the ESP AH, TCP header, data, and ESP TRL, the whole thing is merged again in the case of this transport mode. In the case of this transport mode here. So the limitation of transport mode is that no gateway services we can provide here, and it is reserved for some point-to-point communication as it is shown. So the limitation of transport mode is that no gateway services can be provided, and it is reserved for point-to-point communication, right? Secondly, there is another mode that is known as tunnel mode. The second part that is present here, that is tunnel mode. What is the scenario in the tunnel mode? that this mode, this tunnel mode of IPsec provides the encapsulation services along with other security services. So what is extra features added? Encapsulation services was added along with other security services. Right. Next, the tunnel mode operation. The entire packet from the upper layer is encapsulated before applying any type of security protocol. So the tunnel mode operation, the entire packet from the upper layer is encapsulated before applying any other security protocol, and a new IP header is added. So this diagram, again here we are going to see a similar type of diagram of this. The scenario is, yeah, we are going to talk and discuss on this. That firstly, a network IP header, TCP header, and data will be there. In the second part, the IPsec applies the security protocol. Means whatever the security protocol was added in the last, in the case of transport mode, that was added in first. So ESP AH was added in front of the IP header, TCP header, data, and ESP TRL at the end. Now, then the IP header will be separately or built. A new IP header was built by the IPsec. So I will draw the last one only, and what it looks like at the end. The scenario looks like something like this. IP header, then ESP AH. I think it will be not completed in this page. Better, I will move on here. IP header, ESP AH. Then again, IP header. Then after that IP header, there is a scenario of TCP header. Then the scenario of data. And lastly, ESP TRL. The last scenario looks like something this in the tunnel mode. Now, what is actually changes here? First, let me complete this. Okay, the scenario looks like something this, that this is the primary part. IP header, TCP header, data, it is the primary part. IPsec applies some security protocol of this ESP AH and ESP TRL. The security protocol was added. Then what happened? IPsec builds a new IP header for this particular protocol, and then it was totally reassembled or totally merged. So I have drawn the last scenario here. So totally the last scenario that we have drawn, I have drawn here. So the IPsec protocol for the tunnel mode, it simply looks like this, whereas in the, so what is the difference between transport mode and tunnel mode? We can say in transport mode, what happens that first IP header is isolated, but in the case of the tunnel mode, in the case of tunnel mode, IPsec apply some security protocol. Right, so IP header is isolated in the part of the transport mode, and IPsec applies some security protocol in the tunnel mode. What happened transport mode? That no added header was built, but in the case of tunnel mode, a new IP header was built. Right, so more appropriate security protocols are much more extra features was added here to get the facility of this, and here the tunnel mode is typically associated also with the gateway activities, whereas the transport mode is not associated with any kind of gateway activity. And the encapsulation provides the ability to send several sessions through a single part of gateway. So this is the scenario, the tunnel mode communication. We can say that endpoints are concerned and have a direct transport layer connection, and the datagram from one system forwarded to another system. And lastly, we can say the IPC, the tunneling mode, can be established between the gateway and individual end system. Right. So up to this particular part, we have talked, we have discussed. In the next class, we are going to continue with the IPC protocol, the authentication headers, what are the present. We are going to talk and discuss on that particular scenario. Right. So after this, today we are going to discuss on this IPsec, the tunnel mode that we have covered. Okay. So thank you all for joining into the session. By the time, we will meet again tomorrow in the next class. So take care and stay safe.